Pros Tip, brought to you by Pelagic, high performance offshore gear.
Hey guys, welcome to this episode's Pros Tip. If I could leave you with one thing, if I can provide you with one really vital tip when it comes to slow pitch jigging, it's something that, you know, I'll call jig awareness. It's having a clear understanding where your slow pitch jig is in the water column. How does it fall? How does it flutter? Where is it, you know, in conjunction with the sea floor? When does it make contact? How high is it off the bottom when you're working it back to the boat or just fishing a particular strike zone? You know, having that knowledge is absolutely crucial to successful slow pitch jigging. And only when you truly are one with the jig and in harmony with the jig and you're able to control it and to manipulate it, longer sweeps or just slower, short, little pumps, okay? Or an erratic action, mixing two different pitches together. I can go full revolutions, I can go half revolutions, quarter revolutions, and really make that jig react the way that I want it to react. And only when you reach that point are you really going to start to achieve consistent success slow pitch jigging. It's not just the lure, it's an entire system. It's the lure, the leader, the line, the rod, the reel, it's everything. But most importantly, it's you as the angler. And really, practice. I can't stress it enough. I mean, it's so important, practice. Every time you go out there, you know, make sure you've got a slow pitch outfit on the boat. Any sort of hard bottom, drop that jig. You see fish busting up on top, tunas, kings, drop that jig. Okay, and just work it, learn it, live it, and love it.